Welcome back, everybody. We got Melody with the team for the first time in 2021. I feel like we ain't talked to you since we had an old president.
Exactly. Happy New Year, guys.
New Year.
You going down.
Guys, I'm enjoying the new year. Has 2021 been treating you right?
Right.
You got real 2020 vibes to me.
Yeah.
It definitely has some 2020 vibes. You know, I feel like I started the new year out on a good foot, and then the Shade Room this week just kind of, you know, took my heart and stomped on it. Michael B. Jordan is dating a young lady.
Lord.
I'm not going to say her name.
Lord,
I mean, you can say her name. I'm not going to say her name.
She was talking about Steve Harvey. You gotta act like a lady, think like a man.
You know what? I never put that together. Too right. I don't think nothing wrong with Lord.
I know that you were hurt. I know that there are plenty of people that have been affected by this. But
why?
The real question is,
because he is fine and we were rooting for him. And honestly, like, if I'm like being honest, I really thought that Michael B. Jordan, you know, preferred to date white women. And the fact that he has started dating a sister is a plus, but like, really, this is who you're like really seriously out here on Instagram and taking vacations with? Like, DMs and was like, sir, I thought we was gonna be together now.
One applause at, what's wrong with
it? I mean, I think that
24, we know she's been with 4 or 5 men. I know 24-year-olds that triplet. Come on, it's a good God friend woman, man.
My church, you seen her
Instagram.
Wow.
Sunday service.
It's fine. I'm rooting for them, I guess. I want them to be with a sister, so, you know, it is what it is. Yay, them.
The real question is Future the secret ingredient?
Listen, now that is the real question, because, you know, Ciara and Future, and then she got Russell, and now Ciara and Lori, and now she got Michael B. Jordan. And I just really don't want to have to go through a toxic, trash person.
You don't want to hear about that.
How dare you say that?
And you know, I think Future is toxic.
He is toxic.
First of all, he was hurt too. That girl went public with Michael B. Jordan and put him on the actual Instagram page, and not her story. Oh, Future deleted all his pictures.
Man got a whole new girlfriend. What's her name, Jess?
We don't know.
Oh, y'all don't like
her. We don't know her either.
I ain't gonna learn her name. It's gonna be a new one in a few weeks.
So what? Y'all started off on the wrong note. Because you never been her feelings. Y'all ain't gonna talk about the white people storming the Capitol?
Oh,
we can save them for last.
So my thing with,
I thought y'all jump off the porch. Okay?
No, my thing with Lori Harvey and the whole Future thing is, I feel like Ciara was given such a hard time whenever she got with Russell Wilson. They were like, she done been with 4 or 5 different men. She done been with 50 Cent. She done been with Bow Wow. Like, just drug through the mud. And Lori Harvey, I don't know. I mean, she's getting a real break.
God for your girl, yeah.
What was the difference between her and Ciara?
She ain't done nothing. Every time I see her on Instagram, she with her boyfriend.
Yeah,
she don't be wilding out. She don't go out to the club. She don't be twerking online or any of that behavior. Every time I see
her. And neither did Ciara, but y'all still drag her. Ciara posts a little Future, and here she goes, oh my God, she's so lame. He's so lame. Blah, blah, blah.
That's not bad. She's not bad. It's okay to be lame. Boy, get it.
Speaking of toxic men, YFN Lucci. Regina, you gotta let YFN Lucci go.
She gotta speak about me.
No, it's time to jump ship.
By her man.
How old is she? And did she just turn 21?
Too young to be trying to speak by a man that's got a murder charge. He going to prison. That's not jail.
Allegedly.
Okay, that's fine.
innocent to prove guilty.
What happened?
Come on now, you can't turn your back after 2 days.
What happened?
I don't even know why FN Lucci like that, so I mean, it is what it is.
She came out and put that message out. I just keep going to let you guys know he's in good spirits, ma'am.
That's what she told us to be doing.
No.
It's been 2 days.
She's 21.
It's all right. They run in the streets. No. They come with the streets. You know that.
Next conversation.
We just ain't going to agree on nothing today.
I mean, it is. Well, let me tell you what we can agree on. Are you happy that Kim and Kanye are going to call it quit?
Why would I want why would I want to see these people standing fall apart, man? No, I'm not happy about that.
Okay, so let me tell you, I'm not happy that his family is falling apart, and hopefully it won't fall apart. I honestly don't think they're getting a divorce. I just think that they're trying to beef up the media attention around this last season of Keeping Up with the Kardashians. I don't think they're really getting a divorce. I don't think she's really going to leave Kanye. I mean, I don't know.
She'd be a fool.
She would be a fool?
I don't think nothing wrong with Kim either.
I can't get out of jail. I just know a good album. She had one sex tape with her boyfriend at the time. I do not like him. If they do separate, I'm gonna buy the album. Culture Votes and Black Culture. Now that is what she does. You mind, man? They let her. And that is what we do. We let people profit off of us, and we gotta learn to do better about that. But yes, I would agree. I mean, the album is definitely going to go hard. I hope, you know.
It's going to be gospel music.
If you want to believe that, that man going to have a full breakdown. He probably going to have a song that says F Kim, and he's just going to be saying it 100 million times all over.
Got a man on me, I got God on the side.
If he did My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy after him and Amber Rose, I know this new album's gonna be fire.
It's gonna be gospel, so I'm serving.
Okay, I'll take that.
Man running for president. He not doing that.
Mm, he walking.
Things coming to an end. Issa Rae announced this week that this will be the final season of Insecure. I have mixed emotions. While I agree that, you know, I want them to go ahead and end it on a note, still wanting us wanting more and not really kind of doing these far-fetched scenarios in the upcoming seasons, I'm sad that it's ending because I really like the show.
You need to watch it. I think you like it.
You don't watch Insecure?
I just need a J.R. Ellis sex scene every episode.
Who he gonna be having it with? Because if Issa is back with him, I'm definitely not watching it. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna be with no man and he about to have no whole baby with another, with Condoleezza Rice.
That ain't his fault. He asked her if she was gonna have an abortion.
Maybe I need to watch this.
She said she
gonna... You do need to watch it because I would like to get your opinion on it, but I mean, I don't know. I don't even know how Issa and Lawrence can even work through it. And I'm not even upset with Lawrence. It is what it is. You know, I've talked to you about how I felt Condola just, I don't really understand the logic. You weren't ready to have a baby with your husband, but you ready to have a baby with a dude that you didn't even really want to come to your Thanksgiving dinner with your friends. Make it make sense, ma'am.
Trash.
And
I might take this out. But since y'all talking about, what's her name? Issa Rae.
Issa Rae.
I saw her and Jasmine Sullivan tweeting back and forth about soon.
Working together.
Yeah. I listened to it yesterday at work.
Listen. That new Jasmine Sullivan is something serious.
I think men should listen to it.
I think
he should too.
I think it's a real good listen for me. Because G-Ho is crazy.
No.
Jesus Christ.
It's
why are they crazy?
I didn't listen to the music. Like, for real, I really listen to the music and it's real. So
it is real. It is real. It goes through different parts that you kind of go through in a relationship or just in life because
in the story, I think it's well put together. Front to back.
Yes. Do you have a favorite song?
To that toxic mess that many times.
Whatever.
Not yet. I don't listen to it one.
My favorite skit is the one where she said that men can't handle like the things they dish out.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah. How are you supposed to? But you know, that's another conversation for another one. I don't think we're supposed to. I don't think we built the same. I don't think men supposed to feel like women or women are supposed to feel like men. So no, I shouldn't be able to take what I dish out.
Why are you dishing it out though?
Why dish it out?
Man, I make different decisions. We wired different. Should be. In 2020, you know, ain't no pronouns, so maybe not, none of them. Now that, you know, we ain't wired different. We all wired the same.
What do you think about plies in the new grill?
Plies.
I think he looks like he like boys, man. I ain't gonna lie. I think Clyde kind of looks like he like boys. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I need to put some gold teeth back in.
I'm glad the gold teeth are gone.
I'm glad the gold teeth are gone. And the new teeth look nice.
I can't take back when all that was going on, 04, 05, when everything was popping.
He was jumping out the bush.
Smile for me, daddy, let me see you grill. Yeah,
yeah.
It was a real vibe, but
maybe I didn't like the picture he posted. Mm-hmm. It looked it real.
He looked lit.
With a smile.
Oh, hey, I just think he should have picked another pose. That's all.
He looked blessed. He looked nice. I approve of the new look, Clyde.
It was amazing, gentlemen.
Yeah.
Is that what you asked?
I approve.
I don't know.
Okay. Last but certainly not least. Yes, yes, the short people. I call them short people. The short people storm in the Capitol.
You said short people, I thought you was about to talk about something along the lines of a...
Okay, well, we can take that part out then. Well, let's just talk about it. The people that stormed the Capitol, the Trump supporters that stormed the Capitol, the patriots, as they call themselves, that stormed the Capitol, I just really think that we are living in a time where people are used to instant gratification and everybody getting what they want. And even if you did not agree with the winner of the previous election, I just don't feel like what they did was appropriate. And if you find yourself trying to defend it in any way and say that they are, you know, Americans and patriots, anything like that, like, you really don't care about America, because that did not paint us in a good light. I mean, America is just the ghetto. It's horrible.
Unpopular.
A lot of aliens pass us over.
I got an unpopular opinion about this.
Okay.
People asking, why did the Black Lives Matter people get treated differently for peaceful protests than the white people got treated for storming the Capitol?
Okay.
It's barely. So you don't have a Capitol to storm. They storm their own shit. You know, shoot nobody for breaking in their own house. Now when they got to hurt the police officers and shit like that, it was different, but...
Well, I feel like, I was happy that there weren't many Black people that were out there that tried to go make that into like their own fight.
Right.
I definitely think that it just showed, because okay, so if you look at Black Lives Matter, like, we were getting shot up for storming Target and CVS, and them people got insurance on their stuff. But these people, and even if the Capitol don't belong to us, like, That hasn't been done.
I'm justifying it.
I know, I'm just saying, but like, it hasn't been done in history. I think maybe, I don't even think the Civil War, like, they actually made it to the Capitol.
Right.
The Capitol. Like,
they got invited, though.
And then they were invited. They were invited, but the crazy thing, when I watched it, I'm like, do these people not have jobs to go to next
week?
Yeah,
they got vacation.
And then
the Rouse men let their people out first, you know.
And then like now all the backlash that people are, now that they're having to face consequences, like being put on a no-fly list, now they're all up in arms. And
those videos are my fave.
They want sympathy, and they want people to be able to console them and be more understanding of what the choices that they made. But it's just crazy. But you're right. I think they were invited by Donnie.
Definitely. And he definitely incited that crowd. I mean,
Donnie ain't do that. That was the senators and the people who was at the building.
I feel like there are multiple people responsible, but he's definitely at the top.
Donnie told them people to stand back and stand by.
They don't mean to show up. They mean go to the house and just chill.
What that mean?
Now done with that shit.
Yeah, why he is. I wonder how long him and Melania are going to stay together after they move out.
I don't know. Everybody else turned their back on Trump, so I don't think he got along with her either.
He probably packing.
I just know that all the people that were part of that staff, like, I know they trying to shop their book deals around to get the highest paid right now.
And they're trying to, you know, separate themselves from him now. Don't resign now. You got 10 days left. Don't do that now. You knew this man was a fool a long time ago. Don't do that.
Trump's a thug, a gangster.
Yeah, I like him. No, not as a president. That's an individual. I like him. You're inspiring to me. I'm sorry.
You can be anything you want to be.
You can be anything, and I stand by that. I don't ever want to be told I don't have the experience.
I act how I want to act on the way to it, too.
I don't ever want to be told I don't have the experience. Excuse me?
I stay the course. It's going to be all right.
Mm-hmm. Well, what else are y'all listening to besides Jasmine Sullivan?
Let me see. That's it. That's all that came out this week, I believe.
That's all I've been listening to.
That's all you've been listening to. I've been listening to the new Tink. I like Tink. And I'm still on that 2 Chainz pretty hard.
Adrenal. Oh, favorite. Oh, artist. Hey, look. No, it's a dude. Y'all know I like some walk. No One Know Him.
Oh, okay.
Pretty tough. Y'all gotta check that out. I think you should. Okay. That's my
I'll look him up.
Mm-hmm. All right. Any New Year's resolutions or goals for the new year? Because I'm not calling my own resolutions. I'm saying that I have new goals.
Nah, I just stay consistent with the goals I already have set in front of me.
Okay. Drina, what about you?
To stay consistent and to get 1,000 followers on YouTube.
We gonna work on that thing.
Good go.
You be where the money resides.
Honey, that's it.
You hate it? I hate that so many people
are taking it. It ain't, you know, the however he is. This the voice. He don't sound like he looks, so it sounded weird.
Oh, Mary had a little lamb. Mm-hmm. And that's on Mary had a little lamb.
And that's on Mary had a little lamb.
That is.
That I have for this week's edition of Melody with a T.
Oh.
We'll see you next time.
Go Saints. He is. Go Saints.